Hello everyone, and how are you doing? In this quick tutorial, I'll show you how you can slow down your game to simulate like a pause menu, or how to collide with an object and then make or slow down an enemy. So let's go ahead and see how to set this up. So first I'll click on preview and maximize this, and the first thing I would like to do is to press the P key so that I can slow down the game. And I press the P key again, and I'll actually unpause the game. And that's basically setting the time scale of the game to 0 and 1. Next, I'll show you how you can slow down an enemy. If I walk into or collide with this black section, we can actually see our snail moving slowly. And if we step out, our snail is going to get back to his full speed. So let me just go ahead and turn this off, and I'll show you how you can set that up. So the first thing we'll do is to create a scene variable. So let's go ahead and click on this wrench icon, go to edit scene variables, and let's go to add a variable, and let's call that pause. And let's set the value of that boolean to let's set it to boolean, and I'll just set it to true for the first section. So I have that scene variable. So next, you can actually create an object, and let's go ahead and look at our layers. So I have a layer right here called All Enemies, and to create a layer is super simple. All we need to do is to just go down here and go to add a layer. This is add a new layer, and you can call it whatever you want. So I have this layer called Enemies. Now let me go ahead and pick one of my enemies. You can do this with any object in your scene. So say for instance, if I click on the slug, you notice that I'm on the All Enemies layer, right? So that's quite important. And for this object, I just created a black object using, I went over here and said add new object. I clicked on sprite and I said add animation. Went to edit with pixel. Sorry, I'll just class it at edit with pixel. And once Piscale is opened up, I just selected a color. I left it on black, but you can select any color you want. I just click this right here and filled it up, saved it, clicked apply, and I could just drag this to the scene as a new object, just like that. So basically, that's just what I did right here to get this object called slow-mo. So now we've gotten the two things we need. First, we have our scene variable called pause. And we're going to be calling that in our editor environment. And the next, the other object we have here is called slow-mo, which I've set to the base layer. And then I've set one enemy object to a layer called all enemies. And we'll see why that's important in a second. So next, let's jump into our events and start creating the events for this action. So first, I'll jump to my scene. And I'll check a collision if our player is colliding, or I'll just create the button event first, right? So once we press a key, we'll just toggle an action. So the first thing I'll do is to go to add condition here, and I'll type in key pressed. So it's a key pressed, and a very common button to use for a pause is the letter P. So I'll just click on OK like so. So once our key is pressed, what we're going to do is to toggle the scene variable. We'll toggle the boolean of a scene variable. Basically, we're saying toggle it on or toggle it off. That's basically what toggle means. So I'll just go to add here. So I'll just say the toggled boolean value of a scene variable. And our scene variable is paused. We're just going to set that as OK. So while we are toggling the scene value of a boolean variable, what we want to do is to change the time scale, right, to let's set it to 0. So when the value of the when it's true, we'll actually change the value of that time scale to 0, and when it's false, we'll set it to 1. So let's just go ahead and click on a new event. And let's click on add condition. I'll just say bool. So we'll say the boolean value of a scene variable, pause, and we'll check if that value is true. So what we're going to do is to set the time scale. So let's just type in change time scale, it's right here. Change time scale. Now, 1 is going to be default. So let's set this to 0. So if it's true, we're going to pause the game. And what we're going to do is to select this, right click, copy, and we'll just paste that again. So we'll just change this to false and set the time scale to 1, like so. Right. So let's go ahead and save that. Let's quickly test it. So I'm pressing P, we're paused, I press P again, and we've gotten out of that loop. So that's one good one. So we're pausing, unpausing, pausing the game with P, and unpausing when I press the P key. So what I'm going to do next is to slow down the enemy on the layer when I collide with this object right here. Basically, if my player is in collision with slow-mo, slow down this slug that is on this particular layer called all enemies. So let's see how we can set that up real quick. So right over here, I'll create a new condition and I'll say the player is colliding, has a collision with, I call that slow-mo as name of the object. It could be any object you created, right? So what we're going to do is to, let's say layer. So we're going to change the layer time scale, and it's going to ask us which layer we want to change. I'm going to set it to all enemies, and I'm going to set the, now instead of using 0, 1, we could say 0.5. This is going to slow the enemy by half its speed, right? So will this be okay? I guess this is going to be okay. We'll always find out. So basically, if I'm colliding with that and I have a time scale on the layer, let's slow that layer down. So let's go ahead and save this and press preview. So we can actually, let me maximize this. We can actually see our enemy slug moving around. If I just go in here, we can actually see it slowed down. And we can get back here and see that. So the good thing is we're going to be moving fast, but the enemy is going to slow down. Now look what happens when we're no longer in that layer. So basically that enemy has been slowed down forever. So let me just go ahead and play that again so we can see what I'm saying right here. So our enemy is moving at his normal rate, right? So he's super fast. So once I collide with this, he keeps he's still slow. So let's go set that up again. So basically I'll just copy this and paste it again. Paste it beneath, and basically I'm going to switch the condition. So the collision right here, I'm going to flip it and say our player is not colliding. Let's see, collision. So I'm going to say invert condition and click OK. So basically that means our player is not in collision with slow-mo. I'm going to set the time scale back to 1. So we're going to set our time scale back to normal when our player is not colliding with the power up or the object called slow-mo. So again, let me just quickly maximize this. And once our enemy comes in view, I'll just get in here. He's slow. He's back to moving fast. He's slow and he's back to moving fast again. So basically I can do that, and I can press P to pause the game and P to unpause the game as well. Now this is going to be super boring, because if we have a menu, we could toggle or show that menu. So I actually have an object from my last lesson where I created some sprite objects. I think I have one called, let me see. I can just use pause only. It's an object I have called pause only. So let me just drag pause only to the scene and show you how that. So this is pause only, and it just shows a pause right here. So what I'm going to do is to hide this guy, right? So that when the scene starts, I'm not going to see this guy, right? So I could just do on start of layout. I could just hide this guy. So let's go ahead and do that. So it's pause only. So I'll jump over to my script, and at the beginning, or I can even create one down here. Let's say beginning. So what we're going to do at the beginning, we're going to hide so let's say hide an object. So I think it's called pause only. So at the beginning of our scene, we're going to hide pause only, and when our time scale is set to zero, we're going to show pause only, right? So that means if it's zero, that means we're pausing the game. So what we're going to do is to just simply say let's copy this guy. Let's do a copy and let's get over here. And have I copied it? Just go ahead and do that again. Copy. All right, good. So let's paste that right here. So when our time scale is set to zero, that means we'll pause. We're going to show this guy, not hide it. So let's just double click on this and click on show. So we're going to show pause only. And what we're going to actually do over here is to hide it, hide pause only. So let's go ahead and press save and click our preview. So now our game is previewing, our scene has begun. We can't see pause only. If I press P, we can actually see the pause button. If I press P again, we can't actually see the pause button, like so. So it might actually need a little bit of tweaking because the key press is happening so fast, right, that it's actually doing that a lot. So I don't know, maybe it's my keyboard, but here we can actually pause the game and we can unpause it by pressing P as well. So I think that wraps up this. So it's a very simple way to pause the game. Obviously there are better ways of doing this. If you have more menus, I'm going to be working on a much more fully featured menu because I have the buttons already. But basically that's how we can use a key to toggle and then show our UI items and then hide our UI items when we start. So thanks very much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next quick tip video.